Welcome to MSc Videos. So in this video lectures, we are going to discuss how to write a Java program. So now in this session, we are going to discuss about the introduction part of Java and some history about Java. So before discussing Java, we have to understand what is the essential of programming language. So we are assigning a task to a machine is called as a program. If you are asked to write addition of two numbers, if you write a calculator program, everything is, we want to perform some task, then we are assigning that task to a machine. That's what we are saying as a program. For a successful communication, the language is very, very important. So both the speaker as well as hearer must know the language. So programming language means then we are communicating with the system, so that we have to learn the programming language. So one of the important programming language in recent time we are oftenly using is Java. So Java comes under the category of object-oriented programming. C comes under procedure-oriented, or you can say the structure-oriented. So first of all, we have to differentiate the structure-oriented versus object-oriented. So now I am ready to give some of the few examples to differentiate these two. Now let us consider, so in a classroom, I want to collect the information from the students. So let me say that I want to collect the serial number, or it may be a register number, and then a name, mobile number, address, and then some of the marks, and then a signature. So I am creating a single sheet. Inside the single sheet, all the students have to enter their data. Now what is going to happen? The first student will enter the data, and then the second student will enter the data. While the second student is writing the data, the second student can able to see the data of the first student, as well as the second one can able to change the data of the first one. And similarly, if I am having 50 students are there, the 50th student can able to read as well as modify all the remaining 49 students' data. This is what we are saying as a structure oriented, which means that there is no security there. All the data will be visible to everyone. Each and everyone can access the data at their responsibility. Now, to overcome this, the introduced object oriented, the same scenario, now it is changed. Now let us having a structure like this. A serial number, name, mobile number, address and mark, and then whatever we have been signed. Now there are 50 students are there. I am creating 50 different sheets. Each and every sheet contains this particular table. Now what is going to happen? The first person can able to enter their own data alone. Second person can able to enter their own data alone. Similarly, each and everyone is receiving a separate sheet. So now each and everyone can able to access their own space. So 50 different spaces are created. In their space only they can able to access the data. This is what the main difference between the structure oriented and then object oriented. Let me give another one example. Now this is actually a blueprint of a house. So by using this blueprint, we can able to construct more number of houses, we can able to construct n number of houses. So but it is providing a overall structure for every house. Each and everyone have their own dimensions, each and everyone have their own colors of each and every rooms, so that this particular blueprint is giving the overall structure for each and every objects. By using this blueprint, if I am building 10 houses means, then it may say that all those 10 houses we are saying as an object. Those objects are instance of this particular blueprint. Let me say that this is actually a class. All the houses that are all built, that's what we are saying as an object. And similarly, this is actually a blueprint of a car. So this particular blueprint will provide the overall features of a car. Each and every objects, so if by using this blueprint, if 100 cars are produced or manufactured, means that now all those 100 cars are objects of this particular class. So this is actually a class. So a class will provide the overall architecture for an object. An object will follow what are all the things are provided in a class. So we can have any number of colors are there, and then different parts are available. This is what we are saying as a object-oriented programming. So by discussing more number of programs, you will get a clear idea about this. Oops. Let's comes to Java. So as you know that Java is a high-level programming language. It is initially created by Sun Microsystems in 1995. Now it is owned by Oracle Corporation. It is created by James Gosling. One of the main features of Java is platform independent language, which means that you can create Java in one platform and which can be executed in other platform. That's what we are saying as a platform independent language. It can be executed in any platform. It may be a Windows platform, Mac OS, Unix, Linux, Sun Solaris, any platform. write and compile Java code in one platform and execute the Java code in other platform. That's what we are saying. Java is not a pure object-oriented language, so we can say it is mostly object-oriented language. 99% of time it is object-oriented. Why it is 99% means that it contains some primitive data types, so that it is pure. It is not pure object-oriented. It is actually mostly object-oriented. 99%. So compiler will convert the source code into a bytecode. This bytecode is actually a common for all platform. So that only it is called as a platform independent language. So we are using a just-in-time compiler, which is actually a second compiler. This compiler will convert those bytecodes into a platform-specific executable code. So we are having different terminologies related to Java. So if you want to write Java applications, we need JDK, Java Development Toolkit, and Java Runtime Environment is there, Java Standard Edition, Enterprise Edition, Micro Edition, NetBeans and Eclipse are used as IDE, Integrated Development. You will see shortly what is this IDE it is. And then we need JVM. It's a runtime environment for Java class files. Once you are installing Java in your system, JVM will be created. On those JVM, all your Java program will be executed. So JDK is an environment for developing and executing Java code. And some of the features which are all included in C and C++, which is not available in Java. This is not actually a demerit. So just for differentiating, I'm saying Java does not support pointers, does not support multiple inheritance, and it does not support operator overloading, and then so on. And this is the overall structure of a Java program. Each and every line of your Java program must available inside a class. So class example one, so public static void main. So we'll see in the future classes why it is called as a static. Just I'm printing it, we'll discuss it later about these programs. So variables within the class and outside any method is called as an instance variable. Class variable, variables within the class and outside any method is called as a static keyword. Method is static keyword. And then variable within any method is called as a local variable. So we'll discuss all those variables while we're discussing some examples programs. And there are different data types are supported, integer. So actually integer is a class. These all things are data types, int, short, long, byte, and then float, double, character, boolean. Since these 8 primitive data types are available, so that only Java is called as a not pure object oriented. And then there are some errors are there, paucity. These all errors are common for every programming language. So thank you for visiting my channel. Please subscribe my channel. Keep on visiting my channel. Thank you.